Shalom, brothers and sisters. Raquatas, Akim, Raquatas, Islam, Moors, greetings, ladies and gentlemen. You're now under the sounds of the voice of Kahan Tadada, your brother Tadada, an aggrieved man. As you all know, for the record, this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself competent counsel and then please be advised. What I'm about to give you is for educational, informational, entertainment purposes only. And, as usual, if you need personal coaching, again, we don't offer legal advice, but if you need personal coaching, some type of direction, or if you would like to become a secured party creditor, become a free man, a free woman, click the email link below this video and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. If you find the information which you are about to receive in this video of value, then kindly click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find the video to be worth. You may find it to be worth $200, $100, $50, $10, $5, $20, because it very well may get you out of a situation that may have cost you thousands. So kindly click the link and donate whatever value that you may be finding it worth. Now, although we do not offer legal advice, I want to say that the language used in law is changing. There are many legal phrases that non-lawyers don't understand, don't comprehend. So this video is intended to help non-lawyers understand, comprehend legalese or legal phrases, and to give lawyers guidance in explaining the legal phrases they use if they want to explain those. In most instances, they do not. They want you in confusion. Now, although this video may comprise over a series of videos with, you know, I could go to over 1,400 words or more explaining them, and that still would not be a complete dictionary of legal terms in use throughout the world. But the explanation in this video are not intended to be alternatives. Lawyers or attorneys will continue to use legalese or legal phrases when necessary to baffle you. So this video is designed to explain ideas and concepts rather than give legal definitions. Do you understand? So, you know, I invite your suggestions for additional legal words that you may not comprehend. Just please click the email link below and send us your ideas and just kindly make a donation, and your ideas or your questions will actually be addressed in a video. So we invite your suggestions. So the National Adult Literacy Agency, NALA, you know, people like that, you know, they put out legal manuals and so on and so forth, and it, you know, clears it up some, but it confuses a lot of you. So, you know, with that being said, I'm just going to go over a few legal terms that many of you may not be familiar with, and then I'm going to teach you how to stay in honor. I'm going to teach you to be able to differentiate between honor and dishonor. So the first legalese word that I think you should be, you know what, I'll just start with A, and periodically throughout videos, I'll add a few more terms that many people may not be familiar with. You think you understand it, but in legalese, it carries an entire different meaning. So first word is abonito, which is actually from Latin, which means from the beginning. The next word is abandonment, Now, in common parlance, you think it means to leave someone, but in legalese, it means giving up a legal right, abandonment, an abatement. What is an abatement, Tazi Doc? Well, it's canceling. It's to cancel a writ or an action to stop a nuisance. It's reducing the payments to the creditor in portions if there is not enough money to pay them in full. That's known as an abatement. Or it's reducing the gifts in a will in proportion. So when there is not enough money to pay them in full. Next word is abduction. From the legal lease term, it's taking someone away by force. Most of you may be familiar with that. Above mentioned, it's describing something which has been referred to before in a particular document. Abrogation is an annulment, a repeal of law. Now, abscond is when a person fails to present themselves before the court when required. You know, sometimes you go into acquiescence. Now, absolute means complete and it's unconditional. When you see these legalese terms, you need to be familiar with them because they're not, in most instances, how you've actually been taught in common parlance. Absolute owner means the only owner of property. Obviously, if you're the absolute owner, you know, you have the correct title. You don't have a certificate of title. Do you understand? Do you understand? Absolute privilege. It's actually a defense which actually can be used in a case of defamation if the statement from which the defamation arose was made in either the house of the artist or in fair and accurate news reporting of court proceedings or made during a court proceeding. Now, an abstract title, and by the way, if you don't have a lodeal title to land, you don't own it. If you don't have it to your home, you don't own it. You just think you do. You do not own things the way that you think you do. Now, abstract of title is a document essentially summarizing the title deeds to a property. Do you understand? So, abuse of process is when the court proceedings are brought against a person without any good reasons and with malice. Many of you have actually suffered an abusive process and was not familiar with it. And abuttals are actually the parts of the boundaries of a piece of land which actually touch land alongside. Now, acceptance. You hear me talk about this one quite frequently if you watch my videos. When an offer is accepted unconditionally, a legal binding agreement is created. So, for instance, if a debt collector, a creditor, sends you a bill in the mail and you keep it, then that is acceptance, which is agreement. So you form a binding contract. Me, someone sends me an offer. Hey, Tyler Doc, you owe $50 on such and such. Well, I don't agree with this. I send it back to him with a conditional acceptance. I conditionally accept your offer and proof of claim that you could produce a document with my signature, you know, a contract stating that I agree to the terms of this contract. And I don't want an electronic generated signature. Acceptance of service is when a solicitor accepts court proceedings on the behalf of a client. An acceptor is to organize, you know, which will actually pay the check or bill of exchange, it has accepted. And an accessory is someone who actually engages or helps another person to commit a crime. He was an accessory to murder. And I believe, you know, I'll stop right there. That's enough legal terms for you right now. Now, real briefly, I want to teach you how to stay in honor, or teach you the difference between honor and dishonor. And when you go in dishonor, that's when you begin to get in trouble. So this is one of the most important aspects of law. In law, honor and dishonor. Honor and dishonor is essentially a process. It is what is done in response to a presentment. It is what is done in response to an offer that you may receive, you know, subpoena, or what have you. So throughout the entire process, you must be in honor. Throughout the entire process, you must stay in honor. This applies to everything you do in the legal process. So to act with dishonor towards the other person is the highest sin in the system of law and the legal principle. So, high principles, folks. In ancient times, honor was the matter of being that we now describe as actually having integrity. So, in plain English, an honorable man avoids deception whenever possible. An honorable woman avoids deception whenever possible, treats others with respect, and sticks to his or her beliefs no matter how others think or act. You know, treat others as you want to be treated. So in the scriptures. So personal integrity, allegiance to moral principle. So the ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in the moment of comfort, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy. So said the late Martin Luther King. The difference between a moral man and a man of honor is the latter regrets a discreditable act, even when it has worked and he has not been caught. So, now, there are three ways to honor a presentment. There are three ways to honor an offer. One, accord and satisfaction. Two, conditional acceptance. I conditionally accept your offer upon proof of claim. Three, rejection without dishonor. Now there's two ways to dishonor a presentment. Argumentation. Arguments. This is what lawyers specialize in. They get you to argue because when you argue, they eventually get you involved into an argument. See, to argue means to make clear. You get in trouble when you get engaged in an argument. And number two is silence. Silence, also known as acquiescence. So argument and silence, you go in dishonor. So if we was to put this in practice, if Tyler Doc makes a presentment and Brother Eliar does one of the following. He stays in honor if he's accord and satisfaction. So Eliar honors by accepting the presentment without recourse, and then satisfaction whatever is actually demanded in the presentment by Tazadok. So example, Tazadok presents a bill of service and Eliar pays the bill. He stays in honor. Number two, a conditional acceptance. So Tazadok you know, may send something out. But, you know, Eliyahu honors by accepting the presentment, but with conditions, with conditions. So effectively, that is a counter offer, because a conditional acceptance in truth is a counter offer. Tadadok sends Eliyahu an offer. Eliyahu sends back a counter offer. He stays in honor. So a counter offer comes from Eliyahu back to Tadadok. So Tadadok would then accept the counter offer as a new presentment from Eliyahu. Example, Tadadok offers his house for sale. Eliyahu accepts the offer provided that the house is first painted and sprayed for insects. Number three, the third way to stay in honor is rejection without dishonor. So Eliyahu rejects the presentment because it is actually defected. So Tadadok presents a bill for service. Eliyahu returns the bill because there is an error. You know, perhaps it was not the price that was agreed upon, but we'll accept the bill once the error is corrected. And that's how you stay in honor. Now, how do you go in dishonor? And this is where most of you get in trouble in a public venue known as court. And I encourage you to watch this video at least 4 times. So again, so it can be embedded into your subconscious mind and it becomes just second nature. You don't have to think about it. You just do it. You stay in honor. Now, how do you go in dishonor? Arguments. Many of you, you love to engage in polemics. You love the art of disputation. You love to argue. And that's how you go in dishonor. And the lawyers, their job is to get you to argue. So Eliyahu rejects. He dishonors the bill. There is no basis for rejecting the bill. So the arguments have no relevancy to the presentment that Tadadok sent. So often, you know, this causes the problem. He may send some irrelevant comments and so on and so forth against Tadadok that accompanies his rejections, but he don't have a relevant argument, so he goes in dishonor. The other way to go into dishonor is you play the role of a dummy. You say nothing. You sit there deaf and mute. Someone sends you a presentment. So Eliyahu is sent a presentment. He simply does not respond to the presentment, but remains silent. He goes into acquiescence. The presentment is thus dishonored. That's it, folks. In a nutshell, honor and dishonor. So this procedure, before going into a public venue known as court, and most of these courts are called law courts. So Tadadok makes a presentment to Eliyahu. If Eliyahu honors the presentment, Tadadok acts accordingly. So long as each party honors the other's presentment, the process can move forward to resolution. But if Eliyahu dishonors Tadadok, then Tadadok grants grace and repeats the presentment. So if Eliyahu dishonors Tadadok a second time, Tadadok then makes an affidavit of the history of the presentment. So the affidavit is given to a notary public. The notary is requested to make, in behalf of Tadadok, a formal presentment to Eliyahu. So if Eliyahu dishonors the presentment, the notary grants grace and repeats the presentment. So if Eliyahu dishonors the notary a second time, the notary makes a certified history of the presentment. The history is given to Tadadok. So at this point, Tadadok and Eliyahu's administrative process is complete. I've always told you, if you watch my old videos, court begins with the exchange of documents, not when you actually walk into the physical court. It's a matter of who's keeping the best records. So the affidavit of Tadadok along with the certificate of the notary now becomes the basis for a court actions against Eliyahu. What happens in court, Tadadok? Well, You could think of the court process as a formal series of presentments. So each time a presentment is made, i.e. the court paper is filed, the responding party has an opportunity to honor or dishonor the presentment. And this is where most of you get in trouble. So the response, whether honorable or dishonorable, in turn becomes a presentment. So your objective is to never dishonor the other party's presentment. That's it, folks. This stuff is really simple once you understand it. So if the other parties persist in argument, this is where you get in trouble. Lawyers, I tell you in court, shut your mouth. Everything that you have to say is already on the record. Well, judge, did you not get my record? It's in the record. Did you not get my papers? It's on the record. Prosecutor, it's on the record. Stand mute. Got a question for you? For entertainment purposes, respond back in the form of a question. Stand mute. Say what you have to say and say nothing else. It's on the record. Do you understand? So your objective is to never dishonor the other party's presentment. So if the other parties persist in arguments or silence, you can stay in honor by refusing his argument for cause, stating the cause, and giving him an opportunity to cure the defects. So if he refuses to stop arguing, you stay in honor as he continues in dishonor. So, it brings us to what is known as parens parte. Parens parte originated from the English common law, where the king had a royal prerogative to act as a guardian to persons with legal disabilities such as infants, idiots, lunatics, and the like. So, in the United States, the parens parte function belongs with the states. So, at least in theory, so two reasonable but contending people will honor each other and attempt to resolve the problem at hand. In actual practice, often one or the other or both will act in dishonor. And that is when you screw up, when you go in dishonor. So, if both are acting in honor, the court has nothing to decide. Do you understand? It has nothing to decide, for the parties will work it out together. So if one of the parties is in dishonor, then the court must look with favor towards the man who is in honor. So if parties are acting in dishonor, the doctrines of parens parte becomes effective. So when both parties are in dishonor, either because they are arguing or confused or silent, then the state now has full power to invoke parens parte to control the affairs of the apparently incompetent litigant. That's it. So now you know how to stay in honor, or will you continue to go in dishonor? Stay in honor, you always win. You go in dishonor, you always lose. As long as you remain a debtor, you will always be in dishonor. If you want to be in honor, you must be a creditor. There's no better way to stay in honor than to become a secured party creditor and know how to stand properly as a man or as a woman. And with that, I'm going to bring this one to a close. Once again, I've been listening to your brother Tyler Doc, the Undaunted National. And with that, I'm going to say shalom. I trust that you gather something from this. Watch the video at least 4 times, although I recommend 10. And if you like the video, take 2 seconds and like the video. Subscribe to the channel. Share it with your friends and family. Educate yourselves, learn. So until next time, Tazadok Shabay, signing out. Shalom.